Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is Ray DiAgostino. I am the Vice Chairman of the Lancaster County Board of Commissioners and also the Chairman of the Lancaster County Board of Elections. As we, the Board of County Commissioners and the Board of Elections, have said throughout this entire election cycle and years prior, Lancaster County runs each election with the principles of integrity, veracity, and transparency. It is our duty as elected leaders of this county to conduct elections that the voters can feel confident in. We take that role seriously, and so do the hardworking staff in the elections office and our volunteers. Through training and expertise, it is their work and the work of hundreds of volunteers that allows us to conduct elections that are safe, secure, and allow every eligible voter to legally cast their ballot. The staff takes seriously all the principles that I just outlined and all facets of our election, from voter registration to the publishing of results and all aspects in between. It is through their diligence that our staff uncovered apparent incidents of attempted voter registration fraud here in Lancaster County. Through the staff's normal review process, as many as 2,500 completed voter registration forms are being researched for potential fraud stemming from two separate drop batches by individuals.
So this press conference happened earlier this morning. The county released this media alert, Lancaster County Board of Elections and District Attorney, to hold press conference Friday, October 25th, which is today, at 11:30 a.m. And as you heard them announce there, they discovered 2,500 instances of voter registration fraud. Now, what is different about this in 2020 is that the mainstream media, national press, is actually covering this story instead of sweeping it under the rug as a conspiracy theory. According to NBC, Pennsylvania officials investigating fraudulent voter registration applications in Lancaster County. Now, what I like about NBC's reporting is that they're actually just calling it what it is, fraudulent voter registration. There are no qualifiers. They're not saying alleged fraudulent voter registration, supposed or potential. They are just reporting the truth, which is what the media is supposed to do. Unfortunately, not all of the mainstream media was like that. The Associated Press really watered this down. Pennsylvania County says election workers flagged 2,500 possibly fraudulent voter registrations. But as I'm about to show you footage from the district attorney, that's not what the county is reporting. They are saying that, yes, we know for a fact that these 2,500 registrations are indeed fraudulent. And again, this is a good thing that they caught this early. And so that's going to prevent ballots from being cast and counted in those fraudulent voters' names. Now, NPR, last but not least, they're also, you know, trying to water this down. Pennsylvania County halts hundreds of potentially, again, they have that qualifier, potentially fraudulent voter registration forms. But it is not potential. We know for a fact now, thanks to county officials, that these were indeed fraudulent registrations. Here is the district attorney.
Good morning, everyone. District Attorney Heather Adams. On Tuesday afternoon, I was contacted by Krista Miller, who is our Chief Clerk of Elections, regarding potentially fraudulent voter registration applications that had recently been received by her office. At that time, she informed me that the elections office received approximately 2,500 applications at or near the deadline for registering to vote. While preparing to process these applications, staff noticed that numerous applications appeared to have the same handwriting, were filled out on the same day with unknown signatures, and some were previously registered voters, excuse me, and the signatures on file did not match the signatures on the application. So before I begin to summarize our preliminary findings, I must remind everyone that this is an ongoing investigation, and for that reason, I will be limited in the details that I can provide. Lancaster County detectives began investigating the voter registration applications and immediately found applications that were indeed fraudulent.
Now, I just want to pause right there and say she uses the words indeed fraudulent. There is no doubt about this. The county knows that they're fraudulent. And again, I'm only saying that to point out what the mainstream media is trying to do. Again, the Associated Press, they add the qualifier. Pennsylvania County says election workers flagged 2,500 possibly fraudulent voter registrations. NPR is also guilty of doing the same thing, potentially fraudulent. So again, kudos where kudos is due, because NBC is actually doing their job, which is to just report the news and not add any spin on top of it.
Indicators of fraud included inaccuracies with the addresses listed on the applications, false personal identification information, as well as false names. A number of the applications also contained names that did not match the provided Social Security information. In some cases, applications contained correct personal identification information, such as the correct address, correct phone number, date of birth, driver's license number, and Social Security number. But the individuals listed on the applications informed detectives that they did not request the form, they did not complete the form, and verified that the signature on the form was not theirs. At this point, it is believed that the fraudulent voter registrations are connected to a large-scale canvassing operations for voter registrations that date back to June. However, the majority of the applications received are dated August 15th and after. Those canvassing for voter registrations were employed and paid to obtain voter registration applications. The majority of the applications were from residents in the city of Lancaster. However, applications were also received from residents in Columbia, Elizabethtown, Mountjoy, Akron, Ephrata, Stevens, Strasburg, as well as other locations across Lancaster County. The canvasses themselves took place at various shopping centers, parking lots of grocery stores and businesses, sidewalks, and parks. During this preliminary investigation, detectives were able to verify some of the applications were indeed legitimate. In these instances, the applicant verified that they did provide information to a canvasser. For these applications, we will immediately advise voter registration and that we confirm that they are legitimate requests, and voter registration will process that application. Thus far, of the investigations that we have completed, we have determined that 60% have been fraudulent. That is of the investigations that we've completed. We do have more to do today, and my understanding is that voter registration is still going through the box of 2,500, but should be completed sometime here today.
So there you have it. And Lancaster County is not that big of a county, about 500,000 residents, a little more than 500,000. They are a red-leaning county. So in 2020, they voted overwhelmingly for Donald Trump, 160,000 votes compared to only 115,000 for Joe Biden. In 2016, it was similarly red, 137,000 approximately for Donald Trump compared to 91,000 for Hillary Clinton. Now, I guarantee you the mainstream media has probably reached out. I would like to think that they've reached out, done their job, done their due diligence, really done what they're supposed to do, reached out to the county to learn more about this. And my gut feeling is saying that these fake voter registrations are probably from Democrats. Number one, if Republicans had done this, I guarantee it would have been in the headlines. The media would be covering this. And, I'm going to say this as a minority. Whenever there's a mass shooting, whenever there is a murder, you can always tell whether or not a minority did it based on the headline. Because in the headline or in the byline or just somewhere up top in the article, usually in the first sentence, if it's not in the headline, if it's a white male, they will mention that. Lone white male shooter and rest of the headline. But if it is a minority, and it doesn't matter what kind of minority, Black, Asian, Hispanic, whatever, they won't mention that. They will just say suspect or shooter or alleged shooter. Just watch. Next time there's a mass shooting, pay attention to that, and you'll be really, it'll really open your eyes to the corruption, the standards, and the narratives that the mainstream media tries to push on the rest of us. And I don't say that to be divisive. I just say that to point out the fact that the media has an agenda. And once you can pick up on those patterns, like that one, it's easier to spot the different tricks and sleights of hand that they use to push their agenda. And the other reason I think it was likely coming from the Democrat side is because of what the district attorney said. She mentioned that they believe they have evidence that these canvassers were paid. And, that matters. matches the allegations in 2020. But furthermore, which campaign has more money to spend? Which campaign has money to burn? The Trump campaign isn't doing as well financially as the Harris campaign, so they're really having to be wise with their money. They're spending it strategically in the swing states. They're spending it on ad buys. Whereas the Harris campaign, they have so much cash, they don't know what to do with it. On top of that, the Harris campaign also has a vaunted on-the-ground game that the media is talking about left and right. I mean, which campaign has more on-the-ground offices? Which campaign is known for having canvassers on the ground? Again, not making allegations. I'm just saying, once you start to put two and two together, it's kind of easy to see where this is going. Again, fortunately, the good news is that this fraud of voter registrations was discovered before the election. So that way, we're not fighting over which ballots to be counted. However, the scary part is this is just one county in just one state. Last but not least, as I said in a previous video, desperate people do desperate things. And voter fraud, no matter at what level, whether it's the actual fraudulent ballot or fraudulent registration, is a sign of desperation. Desperate people do desperate things. And which side is the most desperate right now? I would argue that the Democrats are the most desperate. That's why they've really been turning up the Hitler rhetoric. So I don't know about y'all, but I am excited for Donald Trump's rally in New York City this Sunday. He is hosting a rally in Madison Square Garden. But you know, you want to know how desperate the Democrats are? You want to know how terrified they are of Donald Trump actually going into deep blue New York City to campaign? Just take a look at Hillary Clinton. This is last night on CNN.
And you know, one other thing that you'll see next week, Caitlin, is Trump actually reenacting the Madison Square Garden rally in 1939. I write about this in my book. President Franklin Roosevelt was appalled that neo-Nazis, fascists in America were lining up to essentially pledge their support for the kind of government that they were seeing in Germany. So I don't think we can ignore it.
Comparing Trump to Hitler, I mean, pretty desperate, right? Pretty desperate. Desperate people do desperate things. And, you know, in the past, they at least tried to use soft language. They at least tried to couch the extremism of what they were saying. They would say things like, Trump admires Hitler. Trump looks up to Hitler. Trump has a copy of Mein Kampf next to his nightstand. But now they're just flat out saying the thing. They're basically acting as if he's Hitler reincarnated. As you heard Hillary Clinton say there, he is reenacting a Nazi rally. These people, after two failed assassination attempts that we know of, are really stirring the pot. They're really raising the temperature. They're really just asking for violence. So Hillary's clearly stage four TDS, Trump derangement syndrome. But apparently there is a cure for TDS because Michael Rapaport. Now, for those of you who don't know, Michael Rapaport is an actor and he has some of the most deranged views on Donald Trump. The things he's posted in the past are just so ridiculous that I couldn't post them here on YouTube because they're just so outlandish and so out there. Yet, even Michael Rapaport is calling out Hillary Clinton. Hey, pigs are flying right now. I'm telling you, pigs are flying.
F***ing Donald Trump, pig Donald Trump. Call him whatever you want. I've given you gem after gem for years. But stop with the Hitler shit. Stop with the Hitler shit. Do not refer to Hitler and the Holocaust, the actual greatest slaughter and actual genocide of the Jewish people ever for attention and political gain. Stop it. That Nazi rally that took place in Madison Square Garden in 1939 was just that, an actual true blue Nazi rally. So are you saying that anyone and everyone who shows up at Madison Square Garden for this upcoming Trump rally is a Nazi? That's a Nazi rally? Get the f*** out of here. What kind of rallies are happening on the college campuses in New York City, in Union Square, where they're waving Hamas flags and kissing Yahya Sinwar photos? What kind of rallies are that? Do not mention the Holocaust, Hitler, to score political points. When you ignore the greatest slaughter of Jews since the actual Holocaust, which happened on October 7th. All this Hitler talk, all this Holocaust talk, with so little Holocaust studies in schools. Do not bring up Hitler and Nazis when there are 101 hostages, 101 hostages, and you say nothing about them. Cut the shit. Do not use Nazis and Hitler for your agenda when you haven't mentioned the 13 women that are still being held captive today. While you're wearing your futurist female t-shirt, it's disgusting, it's disrespectful to the victims and survivors of the Holocaust and to the real-time victims and survivors and the hostages of October 7th. Stop it!
Can you feel the joy yet? Can you feel the joy? Also, all this infighting that is happening in the Democrat Party right now. I mean, that tells you everything you need to know about the state of the race. If they thought they actually still had a chance of winning, they would be focused on dragging Kamala Harris across the finish line because, you know, she's not going to cross it on her own. But instead, now they are throwing arrows at each other. It's not just Michael Rapaport, by the way. There's a lot of infighting going on. Now, MSNBC, of course, has been one of the main promoters. They're probably ground zero, if I had to guess. I think so. Ground zero for Trump derangement syndrome over there. Well, Keith Olbermann is no longer on their airwaves, thank goodness. But he still is on social media, and he, again, desperate people do desperate things. Listen to how ridiculous this is. This already has 700,000 views on X, has even more on TikTok and Instagram. But again, you can see the desperation, not just in his face, in his tone of voice, but in the ridiculousness of what he's actually saying.
In a bulletin edition of the Friday Countdown podcast, it is absolutely essential for the United States government to immediately sever all connections to Elon Musk and his technological operations, if need be, to seize his assets, including SpaceX, Starlink, and Twitter X, and if need be, detain him, deport him, or take other actions against him. After the Wall Street Journal broke an extraordinary story on Thursday night, to quote it, Elon Musk, the world's richest man and a linchpin of U.S. space efforts, has been in regular contact with Russian President Vladimir Putin since late 2022. The discussions, confirmed by several current and former U.S., European, and Russian officials, touch on personal topics, business, and geopolitical tensions. The journal goes on to report that favors have been asked for the Chinese dictator that Starlink not be used over Taiwan, related from the Chinese dictator in some way to Putin and on to Musk, and that Musk's contact has continued with Putin into this year. Also, you will note the timeline here suggests that Musk only bought Twitter X after his conversations with Putin began, and that there were threats made against Musk's businesses and implicitly against Musk by the Russians. The full details.
There you have it again. They are trying to resurrect Russia, 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 just like they're resurrecting the Hitler hoax and pretty much every hoax. They're running the old playbook of 2016-2020 because they don't know what else to do. Kamala does not have a vision for the future, and that's why they're bringing up stuff from the past. That's why Keith Olbermann is going crazy. And again, which side's the Nazi? Which side's the dictator? Which side's the fascist? You know, is it the one, Donald Trump, the Republicans, who talk about securing the border, who talk about making sure that the American dream is alive and well and accessible for everyone? Or is it from the party that says, no, you can't say what you want on social media. No, if we don't like what you do, we'll collect and seize all your assets, like Keith Olbermann is trying to tell Joe Biden to do to Elon Musk right now. I mean, that is just crazy. When Keith Olbermann posted that, he actually tagged Joe Biden's Twitter account, the POTUS Twitter account, encouraging him to take action right now to seize Musk's account. And the reason Democrats are freaking out, for the first time ever, for the first time in his political career, Donald Trump is not behind in the RCP average. He is now tied for the national popular vote. Wall Street Journal, Trump ahead, Forbes, Trump ahead too, New York Times. The New York Times poll, by the way, their very last poll in 2020 showed Joe Biden ahead 9 points. Okay? Their very last poll in 2016 showed Hillary Clinton ahead by 4 points. So the fact that the New York Times' very last poll of the election cycle shows a tie, that Trump is this much better than he was against Joe Biden, who he barely lost against, and Hillary Clinton, who he won against, is great news for Donald Trump. As always, all of this is just my commentary, just my analysis. That's what's going on in the world from politics from my point of view, and I would love to hear from you. What do you think about this whole brouhaha in Lancaster County? Are you worried about it? Are you happy that the fraud was stopped before it was able to take place? I think this is a call to action for anyone who wants free, fair, secure elections. It's sort of what they say at the airports, right? If you see something, say something. And fortunately, that appears to be the case here. And hopefully, if shenanigans are happening in other counties, they follow the lead, they follow the example, they follow the integrity of what is happening in Lancaster County. Kudos to them. If you haven't already, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. I know it's a simple thing to ask, but it really does help me in the algorithm to reach more viewers like you. Be sure to smash that subscribe button and to check out one of these videos.